I've boiled the potatoes off. I'm gonna grab them here, strain them, and we're just gonna add them back into our pan. About a half cup of milk here. There we go. Gonna add a little salt. Potatoes tend to use a lot of salt. One thing about potatoes, if you're making a chili or a soup or something and you put too much salt in it, you're pouring it in, the cap drops off, poof. What you can do is you can put a whole raw potato in that soup and it'll suck up a lot of that salt. So it's kind of something interesting, something cool to know. Okay, we got a little butter there. Now I'm gonna take a little bit of this coffee. This is geisha coffee. This is a very nice coffee grown here in Boquete, Panama. So what we're gonna do is we're just gonna take just a little bit of it. Our theme today is coffee, which you've already heard about. So let's go ahead and take this on for just a second. Add just a little bit more salt. We're just gonna kind of mash this up a little bit. We started to mash our potatoes here. You kind of see that. All that goodness in there is getting all happy. Now, we're doing a little bit of a rustic. We're leaving the peel on. So it's gonna be this is actually a red potato that we've mashed up. A little bit more waxy than the Idaho potatoes, but one thing we gotta do is we gotta give it a little taste. Yeah, perfect. It's good to season and taste as you go. That way, you get all that good flavor in there. And so, we're gonna set this over here on the stove for just a minute. And we'll come back to that later. So now we're gonna get on to our beef. What we're gonna do is we're gonna take our beef. We're gonna make a little bit of a rub for our beef. So I have a little bit of cumin, black pepper, chili powder, a little salt, a little sugar mixture, a little bit more salt. And then our featured ingredient today, the geisha coffee. So what we're gonna do is, let's just dump all that in there. Mix that up a little bit. So, what we're gonna do is, we're gonna take our beef tenderloins, we're just gonna kinda coat it a little bit. All right, so check that out. Look at that, nice, sear, happiness, love, all that's going on. So we're just gonna flip it again, do this side. Just gonna kind of, at this point, what we can do is, you hear it just sizzling, and the word saute, I think I mentioned this, is French, it means to jump. It's kind of cool, a little science going on in the pan. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take this, throw it in the oven, finish it off in the oven. I wanna show you something. If you can kind of see how some of the fat's kind of escaping, right down there, those little nubs, that's fat like leaving, wanting to escape the heat. So anyway, beautiful, beautiful cut of meat, huh? We're gonna flip it one more time. That pepper, if only you could smell it in here, the pepper, the coffee, the garlic, all of the things going on in there, just really making the kitchen smell nice. So we're gonna put it in the oven and we're gonna go from there. Okay, so what we're doing is we're making a gastrique. Gastrique is a fancy word for something that's just really simple. What it is, it's vinegar, fruit, and herbs. So what we're gonna do today for our coffee concoction is we're going to take cherry, white vinegar, and arugula, and we're going to make a gastrique out of that. And we're gonna finish the plate with that. It's gonna have a nice little zing, cut through some of the heaviness, and it's gonna really balance out our plate with that nice cherry flavor as well. So let's get started. We're gonna take our pan, we're gonna put it on the heat, and we're gonna add our fruit. So what I just have some cherry preserves here. So we're just gonna take a little bit of this. Get that going, get that all happy. And then what we're going to do, look at that, looking good, huh? So we're gonna add a little vinegar to this. Now again, this is to just balance out the dish. We're gonna have a little bit of heaviness, and this vinegariness will kind of cut through that and balance out everything. So we're gonna add a little bit of salt to this, and then I wanna add a little bit of sugar to this as well. And then we're just gonna hit it with the arugula. Arugula is a kind of a spicier, crunchy leaf. I really like it. It's good to finish salads with. It has kind of like a peppery, almost wasabi, horseradish kind of flavor to it. Nice little bite at the end. I really like it. So if you want to see the bubbles, they're kind of, the liquid is reducing. Everything's getting all happy in there and it's coming together. So give this about 2 minutes on the stove. You can see how it's kind of thickening up a little bit. And poof, we have a gastrique. You can do this with blackberries and mint. You can do this with raspberries and cilantro. There's really an unlimited amount of combinations that you can do. So I think this one, the cherries and the arugula, will go great with our beef and our coffee dish today. So that's the gastrique. Okay, so what we've done is we've sauteed our beef tenderloin in coffee, cumin, chili powder, a little bit of salt, and a lot of love. So what we're gonna do is we've seared it, we've put it in the oven, we've pulled it out of the oven, and we're just gonna take it and we're just gonna set it on this plate for a minute just so it can rest. Now this is where our cappuccino sauce is gonna come into play. These wonderful little drippings here, not garbage at all. We're gonna add a little heavy cream to this. We're gonna add a couple little things of butter. And this is gonna be our sauce. We're gonna turn that down, let that get kind of happy in there. All right? So what I'm gonna do is grab the, I have a couple different salts here. This is a local company here in Boquete. They are called the Salty Sisters, and they have some nice infused salts. This one, wow, it's the smoked applewood salt. It's phenomenal. So I'm going to add a little bit of that into this to give it a little bit of a smoky flavor. All right. So we're at the best part. We're going to plate it up. So what we're going to do is we're going to take our gastrique. Now we're just going to take a spoon. Okay. And just kind of go around, make a nice little circle there. All right. Now I'm going to take our mashed potato that we made. I'm just going to kind of put it right there. All right, we're gonna take our beef tenderloin, just set it right on top there. Now, we're gonna take our cappuccino sauce and just kinda give it on there, give it some love. All right, I wanna finish it with just a little bit of this espresso salt. And this is a couple local ladies that they have this infused salt. It's phenomenal. It's just a little salt that's infused with espresso. There's many different flavors that they have. And then just to kind of liven it up a little bit, we're going to add some microgreens. These microgreens are grown here locally. Microgreens are the baby flowers, the baby roots of the flower, of the broccoli, beets, cauliflower, cilantro. So here we have our coffee plate. This coffee plate, again, it's whipped potatoes infused with some of the Isabel Organic Geisha coffee. And then we have our beef tenderloin that's been encrusted with cumin, chili powder, geisha coffee, a little bit of salt and pepper, and then it's been seared and then roasted in the oven and then finished on the pan again on the stove. And then we have our nice gastrique. The gastrique adds a really nice vinegary acid that cuts through the fat of the flavor, so it really balances everything out. So you get a little bit of smoke, a little bit of sweet, a little bit of tang, a little bit of savoriness in this dish, and it's just got all of it. And to me, that's what really makes a nice plate, when you're able to balance all the flavors and you hit all to the mouth. A little bit of sweet from the espresso salt, a little bit of sweet from the cherries, a little bit of richness from the cream and the butter, the richness of the nice beef tenderloin. And then we have our whipped potatoes, which also add a nice fluffy texture to the palate. And everything is just nice and balanced. So this is our coffee plate, and thank you for watching today.